Hi, I'm Andrew, and today we're going to be tackling tool changer recovery on umbrella-style tool changers. Now, there are lots of different machine configurations out there, and there are hundreds of different ways that your tool changer might fault out. But in this video, we're going to teach you the basics of how tool changer recovery works on a Haas. That's going to get your machine up and running again and get you back to making chips in a hurry. Now, the first thing to remember is, whenever your tool changer alarms out, recovering always starts with, you guessed it, the recovery key. I see down here, I've got a 2066 tool changer home position fault alarm. Now let's go to the alarm page and see what the description for that alarm is. Press alarm, there it is. Basically, it tells me that the tool changer is not in a safe position and I need to hit recover to recover the tool changer. Just like I said, tool changer recovery always starts by hitting the recovery key. Now, it doesn't matter how the tool changer faults out. Tool changer recovery always follows the same basic sequence. Drawbar will unclamp, Z-axis will move to home position, the carousel retracts to home position, and from there you follow a set of steps to remove any tools from the spindle or the carousel. When you hit the recover button, the control is going to walk you through this process step by step. Now, you might get the urge to blow through these screens, but don't do that. It's important to slow down and take a moment to read the on-screen instructions carefully. Now, let's continue with recovering this tool changer, and we'll also look at some tips along the way. So we'll start by pressing recover. Now the machine gives me the option of either restoring the tool changer or recovering a tap. In this case, I'm gonna press F1 to restore the tool changer. Asks me to press reset, I do that. Now it says, inspect the spindle and tool pocket. If the tool is not seated in the tool pocket correctly, remove it, if that is possible. So I'm gonna lean in here and take a look. I can see the clamping fingers are holding the tool correctly and the drive dogs are lined up as well. So we're ready to go. So I'm gonna press Y and the spindle's gonna move up and the carousel's gonna retract. Here we go. Now we're alerted that the tool changer is not at home position. Now this might seem a little bit confusing since we just saw the carousel return to home position, but what it really means is that the tool changer recovery sequence is just not finished yet. It's also asking us to place something soft underneath the spindle in case the tool should fall. Now it's very unlikely that the tool is going to fall, but we're going to put a box with some packing foam in there just to be really safe. So you're gonna wanna put something in the box that offers some real cushioning. In this case, we're using packing foam and we've got a good amount in there to support any tool that's gonna fall in there. So I've got my box in place and now I can press Y to continue. Now it asks me if there's a tool in the pocket directly facing the spindle. And there is, so I'm gonna answer yes. Now the control tells us if there is a tool in the spindle, it must be removed. Basically, what it's telling us is to make sure we didn't accidentally sneak a tool into the spindle sometime during this process. We don't have a tool in the spindle, so we're safe to move forward. I'm going to press Y to do that. Now it asks us to remove the tool from the carousel. Now, before you go in there and grab that tool, put on some work gloves and don't skip this step. It's easy to forget just how sharp these tools can be. And it isn't just the tool that you're grabbing for, but it can be these adjacent tools that you can catch a knuckle on or scrape your finger on. Believe me, I know that from experience. So now we're gonna get in here and get a good grip on this tool. Grab the tool on both ends and give it a firm pull away from the pocket. Now the tool pocket is empty and we press Y to continue. The carousel retracts. Tool changer recovery is complete. And now we press Y to exit. The recovery steps that we've just covered will handle most of your common tool changer faults. But there are times when the recover button is not going to save you. Maybe your tool stuck because of low air pressure, or maybe you have poor tool maintenance. In those cases, you're going to need to call your HFO so that they can help you out with your specific problem. And here is a list of the top 5 things you can do to make sure your tool changer runs in tip-top condition and you don't get any unnecessary tool changer alarms. Provide the correct air pressure and air volume to the machine. Don't allow chip buildup on the shuttle plate and the trap door. Use the correct pull studs. Keep them greased and monitor their condition. Don't use tool holders with worn or damaged tapers. Keep your tool holders and the spindle taper clean. Thanks a lot for watching.